The question is, I need to use the parallelogram method to find the sum of these two vectors, the 80 Newton vector going up at this angle and the 50 Newton vector going down at this angle. And it is giving us a specific method to use. So I don't have a choice. I need to use the parallelogram method. The first thing I'm going to do is take this 50 Newton vector and draw it in a tail-to-head fashion with this 80 Newton one. So basically move this up so that it starts at the end of, or at the head of the 80 Newton vector, goes in the same direction and the same length, but it's just a sketch. It's not going to be exact. So yeah, that's about what it looks like, and this is going to be 50 Newtons. Then the resultant starts at the origin and goes to the end of the path shown by these two vectors. So this is about what the resultant will be, and that's what we're trying to find. We need to find the length of this line and also the angle that it's on. So I'm going to call this angle theta. And in order to do that, I'm going to try using the law of cosines. And the first thing I think I need is to find this angle that goes between the two vectors. So I'm going to name that alpha. Now, how do I find what alpha is? To do that, it's probably helpful to draw the complete parallelogram. So I'm going to put the fourth side of the parallelogram going from here to here. It's really just for reference. But now you can see that since this whole angle is 70, that means this is also 70 because it's opposite that. So this one has to be whatever's left over. This is equal to this, and they all have to add up to 360. So I know that 360 equals 2 times 70 plus 2 times alpha. Because alpha is also down here. So solving that, 360 minus 140, which is 2 times 70, equals 2 times alpha. Alpha equals 360 minus 140 is 220, divided by 2, so alpha is 110. Now, I need to use the law of cosines. Law of cosines, or the cosine law, as it's sometimes called. So that's going to tell me that if I take r squared, put it on this side, that is equal to the square root of the other two sides. So this side here is 80, and this one is 50, so that'll be 80 squared plus 50 squared minus 2 times 80 times 50 times cosine of the angle opposite r. So r is this angle or this side here, and alpha is the angle for it, which we know now is 110 degrees. All I have to do now is evaluate that. So r equals 107.9 newtons. So now I need to know the angle theta. One way to find theta would be to find this other angle, the angle that goes from here to here and joins with theta. So we know that the complete this angle plus theta is going to be 50. So I'll call this beta because I already used alpha a second ago. And you can use the law of sines to find beta. Law of sines. So remember, the law of sines works kind of like a ratio. I want to use the law of sines to find alpha, or sorry, to find beta, which is here, and that allows you to find theta down here, the angle that the resultant is at. And I know the angle alpha up here is 110. So the law of sines says that the sine of an angle divided by the length of the side opposite it are always in the same proportion. So I'll write down the resultant, R, divided by sine of alpha. That should have, and that should be proportional to the 50 newtons divided by the sine of beta, because those are the opposite. So just in case I haven't explained that well, the angle that's here has to be opposite the side that's on the top. That's how the law of sines works. So now I should be able to solve for beta, because the resultant we found was 107.9. That's over sine of 110, because that was the value of alpha, equals 50 over sine of beta. And that means sine, a little rearranging, sine of beta equals 50 sine 110 over 107.9. Sine of beta equals 50 times 110 sine divided by 107.9. About 0.435. Beta is then going to equal the inverse sine of that. So I'll just say inverse sine, and you get 25.8 degrees. So if beta is 25.8, that's still not the answer. That means theta is 50 minus that much. Minus 25.8 makes 24.2 degrees. So that's going to be the answer. The resultant vector, the resultant is 107.9 newtons at 24.2 degrees.